Hello, my name is Craig Mackay and I'm a certified hypnotist here at Freedom Hypnosis in New York. This audio is intended to provide some key information about hypnosis, as well as addressing some of the myths associated with it. Then we will discuss what to expect when coming into Freedom Hypnosis for a hypnosis session. So let's talk about hypnosis briefly. When you hear the word hypnotist, what comes to mind? If you're like many people, the word may make you think of a stage hypnotist who makes people do all kinds of funny or ridiculous things for entertainment purposes. Or you may think of a hypnotist as someone who brings about a trance-like state by swinging a pocket watch back and forth. Now, in reality, this kind of hypnosis really bears little resemblance to those stereotyped images. You may say the hypnotist does not hypnotize the individual, but rather the hypnotist serves as a sort of coach, tutor, or guide whose job it is to help the person become hypnotized. Now, why do I say that? Because hypnosis is actually an interactive process. Now, while hypnosis is often described as a sleep-like trance state, it is better expressed as a state characterized by focused attention, heightened suggestibility, and often an increased sense of self-awareness. Now, hypnosis works with the most powerful part of the mind, the subconscious. And when experiencing hypnosis, the conscious, rational, critical mind slows down, allowing the hypnotist to plant positive seeds of change in the powerful subconscious mind of the client. Now, for more in-depth information on this, please view the in-depth video on our website, which covers hypnosis as well as discusses the conscious and subconscious parts of the mind in detail. So, what effects does hypnosis have? Well, the experience of hypnosis can vary dramatically from one person to another, and also upon the intention of the session. Now, some hypnotized individuals report feeling a sense of detachment or extreme relaxation during the hypnotic state, while others are able to recall memories that appear to be long forgotten. Other individuals may remain fully aware and able to carry out conversations while under hypnosis. So now let's move on to eliminating myths about hypnosis. Now, there are many myths about hypnosis, so let me address some of them here. First of all, loss of consciousness. A person in hypnosis is in an altered state of consciousness, but he or she is aware of what is going on and is not in a sleep state. That's right. Someone in hypnosis has complete control and may speak, open their eyes, move around any time that they wish. There is no loss of consciousness. If you did fall asleep during the session, then you would be woken up by the hypnotist, but there is no loss of consciousness. Number two, hypnotized people do crazy things while in hypnosis. Now, this is also a myth. Stage hypnosis exists for entertainment of the audience, but it has given a very wrong impression of the more clinical hypnosis, which we practice. Now, hypnosis or hypnotherapy exists for the realization of the client's goals, to release limiting or negative habits, fears, or any physical discomfort. Now, we've already briefly discussed this, but number three, surrendering of the will or loss of control. Now, again, hypnotic subjects remain in total control and will never do anything in hypnosis that he or she would not do in their usual state of consciousness, because you are you and you remain you throughout the session. Number four, weak-mindedness. Now, some people believe that intelligence can be a barrier to being hypnotized. Some people believe that they can be too intelligent to be hypnotized. Some may even believe that they're not intelligent enough to be hypnotized. The truth is, it doesn't matter. You only need average intelligence to be hypnotized, because you only need the ability to imagine and concentrate. The very fact that a client is looking for another tool to help themselves with an issue and is willing to do the work they have to do suggests a strong mind. Now, number 5, revelation of secrets. A person will never reveal anything that they don't want to reveal, because they are in total control at all times and totally responsible and in control of their own actions. Very good. Now, a fear of getting stuck in hypnosis, number 6. Now, a subject can't get stuck in hypnosis, because what keeps a person in hypnosis is the hypnotist's constant dialogue. If the hypnotist stops talking, the client will do one of two things. They may emerge from hypnosis curious to see why the session stopped, or they'll be so relaxed that they just fall off to sleep and take a nap, from which they would wake up naturally, just like a nap. Now, number 7, hypnosis weakens the will. Now, a person will not succumb to any suggestion given by the hypnotist that is contrary to their goals and wishes, because they remain in total control. Now, along a similar note, number 8, hypnosis against the will. Now, hypnosis is an interactive experience. It is a useful tool a person can choose to help with whatever issues they need to address. Now, when there is proper rapport, a person's conscious and unconscious mind will be more open to positive suggestions for change. Now, moving on. How does a session work at this location? Well, we offer sessions at our Astoria location, but we also offer telephone and Skype sessions for those who are not able to attend our location. Now, this section will focus on sessions in person at this location. So when you arrive for an appointment here, the session will begin with a discussion regarding your goals and objectives, and you will have the opportunity to have your questions answered, should you have any. Then you simply relax in the chair and the hypnotist will play some relaxing music. And once you are comfortable, the hypnosis session will begin. This begins with what is known as the induction, which is used to create the hypnotic state that we call trance. Now, there are a number of ways to do this, and the appropriate way will be chosen for you. There is an appropriate method for every personality and individual, even those who believe that they cannot be hypnotized. You will remain alert and aware throughout the session, but will enjoy a deep sense of relaxation and focus. And once the induction phase is complete, then the hypnotist will move on to working on the goals of the client. There are a variety of methods used for this. Just some examples include visualization techniques, but there may also be some direct suggestion. Now, what is that? These are suggestions given to the subconscious mind to create the desired changes in habits, thoughts, and behaviors as desired by the client. So these are just two of the techniques used during this part of the session. The client remains completely able to open their eyes, move, and speak at any time should they wish to. But since it is a safe and relaxing state, they often do not wish to. Now, once this is complete, the hypnotist will gradually take the client out of the hypnotic state and will discuss the experience of the client. Then there will be the opportunity to book further sessions and, of course, ask any questions that they may have. So this was just intended to provide some basic information about what you could expect should you wish to come and have a session with us. So thank you for listening to this recording. Should you have any further questions, please feel free to reach out and call or email myself, Craig Mackay, at Freedom Hypnosis. Now remember, the website is freedomhypnosisnyc.com. Again, freedomhypnosisnyc.com. And you can reach me at 646-578-0140. Have a wonderful day. Thank you. Bye-bye.